That ring, which we're going to, and we beat you again, baby, we get 5 minutes with J.D. Costello. And that right there is right down our alley, baby. You know, he's always talking about sissy boys, calling us sissy. Well, how you gonna look, boy, when we get 5 minutes with you in the ring, we're gonna take some hair color and some paint and paint your face and spray your hair.
I like that.
What do you think about that, J.D.?
Hey, Ken, the sum and substance of it all, you guys still figure that Mod Squad's cost you guys the Southern...
All right, Dad.
Microphone. Nobody wants to hear this propaganda from the Nightmares or from you, Lance Russell. Let me tell you the way it is. I want 5 minutes with either one of you. I'll take both of you on for 5 minutes. You two little sissies. I may not can beat a wrestler. I may not can beat a referee. But I can take on you two little sissies. Painting your face up. Spraying your hair. Let me at them. I want them. I want them. Let me have them. Let me have them.
Hey, Lance Russell, can you believe this? He's got the nerve to call us sissy the way he swishes around the ring and his men. Come on.
Hey.
Come on. Hey, J.D., Mod Squad, listen. Hey, listen to me.
Thank you.
Listen to me. These guys are going to feel real funny. They got to come out here next week and tell everybody that they got beat up by two sissies, aren't they?
That's right, baby. That's right.
Well, you got his attention, no question about that. The Nightmares, as they'll be going, there's a match coming up with the Mod Squad, and if they beat them, they get 5 minutes with J.D., Ken Wayne, Danny Davis. The Nightmares will be going against them. In the ring right now, Benny Traylor and Jerry Garman, who will be in a handicap match. And I don't envy their problem at all. They've got a big one, 390 pounds big, and we're talking about one of the most agile giants I've seen in a long time, ever, maybe. Bam Bam Bigelow. Completely tattooed around the head. He'll be in a handicap match with him, and manager Larry Sharp right out there with him. Sharp turns him loose. Larry Sharp.
Bam Bam will be ringing all the bells. Look at this.
Larry Sharp turns him loose, and here he goes with Jerry Garman and Benny Traylor.
Yeah, I call him the double D brother.
Demolished with that slam, and now Bam Bam takes him straight up in the air. Here comes Jerry Garman back in the ring. He was thrown out earlier by Bam Bam.
Yeah, these guys look like the Doublemen brothers, and we're doubling our pleasure and doubling our fun because Bam Bam is the one. Look at him. Beat him up, Bam Bam. Thank you.
Drops him over the knee, and now he's covering them both. Two, three.
Oh, it ain't over.
Hey, come on, Larry. He wins the match.
All the way, Bam Bam. All the way. That's my man you're watching. The beast from the east. Bam Bam Bigelow. All right. Yeah.
Two at once. He doubled our pleasure and doubled our fun.
He comes off the top rope. He had already beaten him, and he demolishes both Traylor and Garman as the beast from the east. In just over 1 minute's time, completely controlled a handicap match and destroyed Jerry Garman and Benny Traylor. Man, oh man, I'll tell you, it's going to take some doing for anybody to ever beat this guy. Larry Sharp, Bam Bam Bigelow, back in a moment.
Some more action back in the ring in just one moment. Hey, time out again to remind you that you folks around Owensboro, there was a scheduled championship wrestling on July the 24th, but it has been canceled due to a conflict in the building, and we'll be announcing the next date that will be coming up. Okay, let's talk about something that hadn't been canceled. I mean, it's only going to be nothing but action going in the Coliseum in Evansville come Wednesday night. Opening match, Greg Gillis against Gypsy Joe. Sexy Ron Sexton will be going against David Haskins in the second match. Then Big Bam Bam Bigelow, all 390 pounds of him, will be going against newcomer JT Southern. That'll be a good bout. And look out for the final three matches. Texas Death Match with Joe LeDuc hitting against Paul Diamond. Falls don't count. You go till you can. Then it's going to be the Nightmares against the Mod Squad. If they win, they get 5 minutes with J.D. Costello. And finally, Jeff Jarrett and Pat Tanaka against Sato and Goto for the title.
Well, I understood, at least I heard and partially understood what Tojo said about the fact that Goto is his cousin and that caused him to leave Jeff Jarrett in the ring. I see and would like to know from you, I see no reason for the interference. Why did you have to interfere in that last match in there that day?
Mr. Lance Russell, I want to tell you something. You mind your own business, I mind my own business. You understand? Your mouth is too big. You understand? My business. You don't interfere with my business. You understand? I want to tell you something. Jeff Jarrett is just very, very clumsy. He was about to fall outside the ring. I just stopped him. That's why. That's the only thing. I don't lie. Japanese don't lie. You understand? Japanese people never lie. You understand? I want to tell you something. Jeff Jarrett, I tell you what, I train him any time. You know, Jeff Jarrett, all he do is eat and sleep. He's retarded. That boy is retarded. He don't know nothing about wrestling. I take my boys early in the morning, 7 o'clock train. They love to train. But Jeff Jarrett, all he do is eat and sleep. That boy is retarded. He think he going to tell the Japanese honorable imperial wrestler how to wrestle. You know that boy is very, very sick, Mr. Rand Russell.
Yeah. You know that you have a match coming up with Sato and Goto against Jeff Jarrett and Pat Tanaka. And the winner of that match is going to be the new international tag champion.
Mr. Lance Russell, I'm going to tell you, and I'm going to predict you already. My two imperial Japanese wrestlers, the great wrestler, they train hard. And I tell you what, they're going to retain, and they're going to take back the international tag team champion again, because Jeff Jarrett and Pat Tanaka is just a punk.
I feel shame for Jeff Jarrett. He's a just boy. He's going to stay forever. Then every chance we get, we're going to show him what kind of man. We're going to show them the difference between boys and men.
When we find out about it, we'll see who's going to be the champion. I'll tell you that for a fact. To the ring go Sato and Goto. And we're ready. Their opponents today from Springfield, Tennessee will be Tracy Smothers and his partner from Memphis, Tennessee, David Haskins, wrestling out of Tokyo, Japan, Akio Sato and Tarzan Goto. Bell time and off and running we go. We've also got Tojo Yamamoto in the corner of the former international tag champions. We'll keep an eye on him. Whoa, a nice drop kick from David Haskins. Hooks the arm, takes him over and down. In comes Tracy Smothers. And I think maybe that Sato and Goto may have overlooked these two guys. In the air with a nice leapfrog. Hip toss, Tracy Smothers. Because Smothers and Haskins both have come a long way. A one count is all he could get. And again, Smothers takes him down and bars the arm. That's Akio Sato, who makes a tag on his partner, Tarzan Goto. And there's no doubt this is a world-class team, Goto and Sato. To the rope, Smothers being chopped hard as Goto blazing away at him, and the referee's telling him, come on, get him off the ropes. Takes a shot, and Goto goes to the eyes. And Smothers right back. What a good effort. Nailing Haskins as he comes into the ring. Rolls him back up, slides him down. Count of one. Ooh, what a nice move from Haskins in the air. Goto and Sato stunned by the unexpected expertise being shown by their opponents. Goto put down hard by Tracy Smothers. Tracy got a one count. Yama Yamamoto up out of the chair watching. Referee comes over to send him back. Sato comes by with a referee's back turn. He nails Mother, so Goto takes over. A tag on Akio Sato. Sato down with a heavy chop. And again, hollers at Goto. Goto, they use his head as a battering block. And Smothers' head slammed right into the top of Goto. And again, he comes off the ropes with a headbutt. Smothers now in heavy trouble. Sato and Goto getting their act together against Smothers and Haskins. Into the foot of Akio Sato. Now with a chop, and a referee has a word to say to Sato. Scooping Smothers up, slams him back down. 3 minutes into the action, we're past the three-minute mark as Smothers and Haskins got off to a great start. And then with a little diversion by Yamamoto, they were double-teamed, or Smothers was, by Goto and Sato. Look at that nice kick. Smothers trying to pull his way down to the corner, but Goto cuts him off. Over the top rope. Snaps Smothers back out into the center of the ring. A knee dropped down. Smothers is covered. One, and at the count of two, Big Tracy kicks his way loose. As the tag on Sato, Smothers needs to get over and tag his partner, but he fights his way back, heads to the corner, tags David Haskins. Past the four-minute mark, Haskins going to work on Sato, whips him in. Oh, boy. Man, David got a little bit too much in terms of being anxious. And he was caught hard. Feet knocked right out from under him. Sato drives ahead into the midsection. One, two. He got him! Goto, that was, drove the head in at 4 minutes and 27 seconds. And the winner, Sato and Goto, over Tracy Smothers and David Haskins. More action in a moment. You're going to see this young man in the ring in action with Paul Diamond as his partner in just a moment. Jeff Jarrett, I think, had a rude awakening, if he ever had any illusions at all, in a confrontation you had earlier with Sato and Goto when Tojo said you were falling out of the ring and he just stopped you from falling. He stopped you, all right.
No, that's right. People know the real story. But right now, I heard Tojo come out here, and I'm confused at what he's saying. He says that I'm clumsy, that all I did was eat and sleep, that I didn't care about wrestling.
Right.
Well, Lance, I'll tell you. When I was in school back in the spring, every afternoon after I got from school, I'd go over there and want to train. When I got out of school this summer, I'd go over there early in the morning and I'd want to train with him. And 9 times out of 10, he'd say, go on, I got to go somewhere, I'm busy. Now, Tojo, Sato, and Goto, they don't think I can become a wrestler. But I'm here to tell you, I want to become a wrestler, and I want to become a good wrestler. Now, we got a match coming up with them, the International Belts.
The winner of that match will be the new champion.
That's right. And not many people think me and Tanaka can do any good or even have a chance with these guys, but I think we're going to turn some heads, and I hope the people come out, because I think we can come out with the championships.
Well, of course, a lot of people didn't think that the first time that when you had Tojo as your partner, before he walked out on you, that you guys really had any chance with such a world-class team as Sato and Goto, but you won it.
That's right, Lance, and we're going to try to do the same this week.
Okay, Jeff Jarrett, and good luck to you, Jeff. Outstanding young athletes. You'll see two of them in here in just a moment.
Oh. You don't need to have a chance with us, much less anybody else.
Pat him on the back.
Big Lou and Jerry Bryant of the Memphis Vice They'll be in there against Paul Diamond and Jeff Jarrett in this tag match. It should be a good team also. Paul Diamond teaming with Jarrett today against the Memphis Vice. And let me tell you, the Memphis Vice has been coming on strong. Before the bell really even gets the vibration out. They're across the ring and jump, Diamond and Jarrett, who reverses. Diamond with Big Lou and Jerry Bryant with Jeff Jarrett. Good backdrop from Jeff. Diamond grabs a hold of Bryant. Jeff covers him up, one, two, and Bryant misses him, and Jarrett pulled out of the way. Nice drop kick, and down goes Bryant. We got them all four in the ring. It hadn't boiled down to a tag team as yet, because the Memphis Vice charged across the ring and jumped Jarrett and Diamond just as the bell sounded. I mean, never even gave them a chance to turn their head. Jarrett in the ring by himself now, and the referee saying, let's get one in here. Snaps, and both of them into the ring now. Bryant goes down. Lou goes down. And it didn't look too clumsy to me. Yamamoto was talking about Jeff being clumsy. An outstanding basketball player. Fine athlete, I think. Climbing through the ropes, Jerry Bryant. Squaring off with Jeff. The referee said, let's open the hands and keep this a wrestling match, not a boxing match. Bryant and Jarrett tie it up. Bryant with the arm wraps it, grabs a handful of hair and pulls him off the feet while the referee is over with Big Lou trying to get him back to the corner. Once again, Lou's got one of those irritating mouths that he will absolutely make you mad. And he's getting to the crowd and the opponents. There's a tag from Bryant on Jarrett. Big Lou put to the midsection. And Lou slams him upside the head. Tag on Jerry Bryant. With the knee of Bryant, a head slammed into it. Jarrett down in the corner. He needs to get over to Paul Diamond, but he's a long way away. Bryant whips him in. Clothesline, and down Jeff goes. They're keeping him well on this side of the ring so he can't tag his partner. Body slam. And Bryant baits Paul Diamond in, so the referee has to intercept him while that's happening. Jarrett caught in the corner by Big Lou and Jerry Bryant. The referee turned around and saw him. Jumped on him right away. They said, oh, no. Over the top and a drop kick. Here's a tag on Paul Diamond. Paul rushes Bryant in. Backdrop. Bryant and Big Lou. Together now with Jarrett on Bryant. Paul Diamond has got Big Lou. Here's Sato and Goto. Jump in the ring. It'll be a disqualification. 3 minutes, 36 seconds. Disqualification. The winners will be Jeff Jarrett and Paul Diamond. But Sato and Goto pounding away on Jarrett. Meanwhile, it's Big Lou and Bryant on Paul Diamond. Here come the Nightmares. That evens things up. And the Memphis Vice and Sato and Goto split. So the winners by disqualification in 3:36, Jarrett and Diamond. We'll take time out. Be back in just a moment.
All right, Wednesday. Wednesday night, Evansville Coliseum, that's where the action is, and that's where you ought to be too, my friend. We're going to be seeing a triple main event. One of the bouts I know that you want to be there in time to see will be when the Beast from the East, Big Bam Bam Bigelow, will be in there against a newcomer to the territory and an outstanding wrestler. We're talking about J.T. Southern. You're getting your feet wet in a hurry, J.T.
Yeah, Lance, that Bam Bam, he's big and he's bad, but he can be had. He's been trashing everybody. But he ain't going to be trashing J.T. Southern that night.
That's going to be a big night. We'll be looking forward to that. You betcha. Wednesday night, we'll be seeing you. International tag belts will be on the line. You're going to be seeing somebody walk out of there with the belts around their waist. Sato and Goto with Yamamoto in their corner against Jeff Jarrett and Pat Tanaka. Jeff?
That's right, Lance. There's got to be a winner, and I think me and Pat can do it. We're awful young to this business, but I think we can turn a lot of heads. And Tojo, if you want to get in the ring, I got something for you, too.
Ooh, boy. Going to be a tough night, Pat.
I tell you what, Lance, Sato and Goto, those were the, Jeff's titles. And I tell you what, I'm going to be there to back him up to make sure he regains those titles.
Good luck to you guys. We'd like to see you with those belts in there. And a match you don't want to miss. Talking about the Nightmares. Danny Davis and Ken Wayne going against the Mod Squad. And if you guys win it,
we will.
5 minutes with J.D. Costello.
Oh, baby, I can't wait because, you know, we've proved already that the Mod Squad can be beat. Anybody can be beat. Even the Nightmares on any given night. But we're not going to give you the night. Well, when we beat you, baby, we're going to get 5 minutes with you, J.D. Costello. Sure. We're going to have this spray paint out there. You know why? Because you're always knocking us about spraying our hair and painting our face, calling us sissies. Well, how are you going to look when we spray?
A lot of folks would love to see that if you get that spray paint and that paint going out there on J.D. Costello. Wednesday night, you'll have a chance to see. Be there.
In the ring right now, and this ought to be a dandy. It's an expiration of time match. We've got plenty of time for action. It's a huge team of fire and flame with J.D. Costello, and they'll be going against the Nightmares, Danny Davis and Ken Wayne. Danny on the left, Ken on the right. They'll be giving away a giant amount of weight, but that really didn't make any difference to them. Starting out, Danny Davis against Flame. J.D. up disturbing the audience here as Flame is in there with Danny Davis.
Lance Russell, I almost didn't recognize you for a minute. It was the best minute I ever spent in my life.
Oh, J.D.
Let me tell you right now about these two little sissies in the ring with the other part of my dynasty, Fire and Flame, because we're going to effectively put them out of wrestling. They ought to be in the New York Ballet. They ought not be in professional wrestling. They ought to be tap dancing in the circus. They don't belong in professional wrestling with the real men, and the real men belong to my dynasty. Would you spray paint your hair? Would you put a star on it? Would you? They're trying to hide something, Lance Russell.
Little mistake, J.D. As the speed of Danny Davis got him out of the way, and Flame caught his own partner, Fire, on the ring apron. There's a tag on Ken Wayne into the ring now. J.D. better watch what he's saying. Those words may come back to haunt him, the Nightmare.
Listen, Lance Russell, I won't take it away from the Nightmare. They exhibit great speed, but my dynasty not only exhibits speed, we're also agile, we're the strongest men in professional wrestling, and the third reason, the most important of all, Fire and Flame, Spike and Basher, the Mod Squad, have me.
I hear that, J.D., and in spite of that, they've got impressive win-loss records, both of those teams. Fire and Flame against the Nightmares is Kent Wayne with a good drop kick after a whip, and Fire goes down on the mat. Danny Davis takes over once again in the center of the ring. This is an expiration of time match, and we've got a good bit of time for this team that would seem, look at here, big splashing cover, but he gets a one count only. They're trying to use the surprise element there to end up getting a three count. That's what you've got to do in a lot of respects with a team of Fire and Flame. They are so big. Danny Davis, Ken Wayne, the Nightmares, pound for pound, just as tough a tag team as anywhere in the United States. Top wrist lock, and it's reversed, but not for long. It's Fire. Once again, they exchange, and there's a tag on Flame.
You know, Lance, I understand since the Nightmares have had a confrontation with my Mod Squad and also now with Fire and Flame, they've had many nights that they couldn't go to sleep. In fact, they've had nightmares of their own since all of this has happened. I understand they wake up, they're scared to death, they break out in a cold sweat, and they've had to go to the doctor, and they've been to several doctors, and all the doctors say that they've got a certain disease, and they call it Mod Squaditis. And the only cure of that is to get into the ring, face facts. It's a day of confrontation with the Mod Squad. That's what they're going to have to do. They're going to have to face up to it. Every time they've attacked the Mod Squad, it's been behind our backs. Now, it takes real men, Lance Russell, to stand face to face. And that's what the Mod Squad does. And you know it, Lance.
Now, I'll remember what you said as I watch your dynasty teams in action. Right now, Ken and Danny are interested in one thing, and that's Fire and Flame. A nice drop kick on the team of Fire and Flame. Right through the rope, they double over. Mashing the big guys down to the mat and right back in the ring. The Nightmare. A rough and tumble pair themselves. They have no hesitation whatsoever about landing on Fire and Flame any way they can. Ken Wayne wearing off with Fire. Bangs him and stops him cold. That was so spectacular. Let's jump in here and take a look at this. After they'd gotten them out on the floor, both of them right through the rope, pound down on them. Man, oh, man. And back to the live action again. Ken being held as Flame comes in and unloads the big dukes on him. Whip into the rope, big elbow, and down goes Danny. Elbow down on him. Is this it? One, two. That's the thing about it, a team the size of Fire and Flame. When they get you down at any time, it could be the count of three. Way up in the air. He threw him. They threw him right up into the light.
We need to move these lights up a little bit, Fire and Flame out here.
Well, I gotta say, they got him right up into the light. There's a cover. Not that easy to get a pin on the Nightmares, JD.
The Nightmares, I give them credit. They've got a lot of speed. They like to come back. You think they're down and out, and they keep on coming back. But Lance Russell, my dynasty speaks for itself.
Well, we'll see. That's what's happening now. The actions are speaking louder than words, and you can see the kind of tactics being used by Fire and Flame. Flame makes the tag on Fire. On the exchange, Ken Wayne plowed right in the midsection. Rattling the head. Ken off the top turnbuckle, followed by a big chop. And there's a tag on Flame. £580 plus of tag team and Fire and Flame. Ken is down, rolling underneath the rope. That may have saved him from a pin right at that point. JD down around. Here comes his partner, Danny Davis, over to help Ken out. As the Nightmare is now on the short end of the stick with Fire and Flame.
Clearly a
apparent that Ken Wayne is down and out. It's almost over with for him, Lance Russell. You can see it, and I can see it, too. You've been doing this a long time. You know when a man's down and out.
Easier said than done, J.D.
Lance, why don't you take a long ball on a short here?
Oh, you make my day, J.D. All bad. And there's a kick out. They thought they had him again. And Ken kicks loose from fire. Over near the corner. Is he going to get the tag? No, sir. Close to Danny. He got it. Here comes Danny, a lot fresher than Ken Wayne. Raked across the eyes and out on the floor goes Danny. Fire and flame, back in the ring. We're going to stop it right here. We got some spectators that were got involved. We've got, this last match was scheduled as a expiration of time match, but I can assure you that that match is completed, and we are not going to have fire and flame back here after the incident that took place out there. Now, J.D.
Now, wait a minute.
Hey.
Don't you say, J.D., don't you say.
We are not going to have you wrestle on television.
Wait a minute. Nobody tells us who can wrestle here and who cannot wrestle here. I've got $20 million that I can buy this studio. I can buy Jerry Jarrett Promotions, and I can own it. Nobody. You know how it happened out here? That fat broad got up and attacked one of them. They touched him first. We have legal rights. Nobody touches us.
We've got no rights to be beaten up on somebody that came here and did it.
Wait a minute. And the bottom rule is nobody can deprive my men from making a living. And that's what they do in professional wrestling. They make a living by it, Lance Russell.
Hey, J.D., I'm not saying they're deprived from making a living. They're just deprived from being here on television. They can wrestle in the arenas. They can do everything else. But they cannot wrestle here on television. We don't want them here anymore. Will you guys get out of here? They were not hit first. Will you guys get out of here?
Defense, Lance Russell.
Well, I'm not going to make you, but by golly, I'll tell you, they've got people who can make you get out of here. They're getting in touch with...
Hey, man.
All right.
We have certain lawyers that can put this company out of business.
Well, let me tell you what, J.D., those kind of guys, when they come around and jump on somebody like that, they ought to be put out of business. All right.
Them bras ought to keep their hands off of me.
We'll take this off.
Yeah, get him out of here.
Somebody to wrestle these two fruitcakes in the ring right now? Is that what you want? Well, you got it. The Mod Squad.
Hey. He said that he's going to go get them. Look out. Spike and Basher. Boy, you got a fine bunch in the Dynasty. I'll tell you what, you really sponsor a great attitude.
Nobody tells us what to do. You got to realize that.
Nightmares. Under normal circumstances, I would love to see a match between the Nightmares and the Mod Squad. And I guess the only thing you can say here is that we'll just sit back and watch a whale of a fight. In the ring, Basher just nailed Danny while Spike, down on the floor with Ken Wayne, slams him on the studio floor. Big suplex on Danny Davis by Basher. Basher covering up. They came running out here, and Johnny kicked out of there. Davis looked like he was all through. Referee's telling him, don't put your hands on me. They're choking Ken Wayne down on the floor. As Spike had his shirt around, Ken Wayne coming after him. Well, this brawl season right all over the place. Head down into our bell is Danny Davis being rammed into a chair at ringside. Can we? Yeah, let's break this thing up. What a brawl. Nightmares, the Mod Squad, the referee stopping it. That's the only thing to do. Well, you got to find Dynamite.
You're seeing a lesson right here. You're seeing a lesson against the Nightmares from the Mod Squad.
You don't see them quitting, do you, J.D.? As Ken Wayne just nailed Spike with a chair. And a brawl goes on. Trying to get some kind of order, not to get it started again, but just to get it all stopped. Mod Squad now with the Nightmares down and JD just pegging them on. Danny draped over the top rope being choked. The referee goes down. Ken Wayne fights his way back with Basher as JD hanging on to Danny Davis. This match long ago was over with. It all happened when... Well, let's wait a minute. Nightmares are still standing. The Mod Squad standing. They didn't run anybody out of here. JD Costello now with the Mod Squad, and they're screaming. confrontation between the Nightmares and the Mod Squad. I want to recap. Hey, let's get everybody out till cooler heads prevail. JG!
No better than anybody else is the time and a place for this. This needs to be settled in the arenas, not right here today.
You got that
everybody
right.
Needs to cool down.
That's right.
Get their heads together, because those boys right there, you aren't going to see them a week from now. You aren't going to see them because they're not going to be around here.
You're right about cooling down. Everybody is fired up and hot and all of that. Okay, a little excitement we had today. We don't need any more of that next week, but we'll have plenty of action. You can bet your life on that. We'll be looking forward, hoping maybe Davey will be...